Welcome to the WMUR Primary Vault. I'm Adam Sexton. Firefighters are known for saving lives, but here in New Hampshire, they also have the distinction of having saved a presidential candidacy. In mid-2003, as Democrats were buzzing over Howard Dean and Wesley Clark, then-Senator John Kerry received the endorsement of the International Association of Firefighters and their local arm here in the Granite State, the Professional Firefighters of New Hampshire. Even as the senator's poll numbers were tanking, the firefighters kept voters coming to see him with a series of chili feeds. Here's our own Jennifer Vaughn profiling one of Kerry's last such events of the cycle in December 2003.
John Kerry believes one surefire way to the voters' hearts is through their stomachs. It's a given in New Hampshire politics if you want to pack a room, offer free food. And Kerry's signature event is the chili feed. It's the brainchild of his supporters.
We had some great firefighter support, and the firefighters like chili, firehouse chili. So we just thought it would be a great way to meet people more informally. How are you doing? Great to see you. How are you?
When Senator Kerry isn't working the room,
I hope you can belong to me too. I want your vote.
He's behind the table, serving four alarm chili to anyone who wants it. And this stuff is homemade.
Usually I just took the Hormel can and dumped it out and heated it up. But these guys do the real thing. They really kick it from, you know, from scrap.
When the food is consumed,
was the chili good? Anybody got an ulcer?
Kerry likes to really give people something to chew on. He offers his audience his plans for the future. He'll answer questions and try to pull people into his corner.
Thank you very much.
Kerry has held dozens of chili feeds all around New Hampshire. He's confident he's done much more than simply feed the hungry.
You've got it on now.
Thanks, man. An awful lot of people come up, say they're switching from Dean or they're supporting me, or I convinced them tonight they were undecided.
Joining us now is Professional Firefighters of New Hampshire President Dave Lang. Thanks for joining us here, Dave.
Hey, thanks.
Your endorsement of John Kerry came 12 years ago this month. At the time, he didn't look like a candidate on the path to the nomination. So why did your organization, your guys, choose to get behind Senator Kerry?
Well, as the campaign slogan went, John Kerry was the real deal. He was the real deal for America. He was the real deal that New Hampshire had to get to know. The New Hampshire primary is just a wonderful place for presidential candidates to come out and have a conversation with real people and real folks. And John Kerry actually did that, and he listened. If you remember when John Kerry first came in, there was a debate going about his hair, you know, did he do this, did he do that, would he do a Botox? There was all kinds of different rumors going around, and John Kerry landed in New Hampshire with the firefighters' endorsement, and the real deal is really what carried us and began the momentum that we were able to see.
Who came up with the idea of chili feeds?
As a matter of fact, it was our leadership team that did that. In the previous presidential primary, Al Gore had a challenge. And the Manchester firefighters actually did a spaghetti feed. And so some of the folks in the campaign that were working with Senator Kerry called us and said, hey, could you guys do a spaghetti feed? And we said, no, we're not going to do a spaghetti feed. We're going to do a chili feed. And they said, well, what's that? And they said, well, we make firehouse chili. And we actually, the very first part of it, we sent out invitations to the community and invited them to the firehouses and said, we've got a candidate as hot as our chili. Come on out and meet the candidate. And people responded, and they came out to the firehouses. Remember, this is after September 11th when we lost 343 New York City firefighters. And there were some things going on in the country that really weren't kosher for us. And it was they were closing firehouses in New York City, and they weren't, they're opening up, and it was one of John Kerry's lines, is we can't be closing firehouses in New York City and open them up in Baghdad. And that's one of the things that really resonated with some folks.
When did you start to see the momentum build? Obviously, poll numbers were not great at all in the summer, but when did the chili feed start to produce results?
Well, for us, we believe it was when John Kerry came out from behind the podium and he got behind the kettle of chili and he picked up the ladle and started serving. And because what that was that truly the best of John Kerry. See, John Kerry was a servant leader. He was in the military, and we needed to have people see that servant leader. So when John Kerry served that chili and he talked to folks as they went through the line, and then afterwards he, matter of fact, there was a period of time that I think he spilled more chili on himself than he served. You'll see some shots of John Kerry with the firefighters' windbreaker. We had to give him that because he had to go to other events and we didn't want him splashed with chili like he sometimes did.
What did you learn, or what was affirmed for you about the New Hampshire primary by what John Kerry was able to accomplish with your help?
Any presidential candidate, anyone that comes into New Hampshire and does not give access to New Hampshire voters, that does not sit in the living rooms and come to the firehouses and go to the community centers and have a conversation with New Hampshire people, and I don't care which party it is, they're destined not to win the New Hampshire primary. I mean, that's just a fact. I mean, it's proven time and time again. New Hampshire takes, our people take this very seriously. I like to say when I travel across the country and talk to my counterparts, our folks believe this is on their birth certificate. And they really buy into it. They take it serious. They take their role serious. They ask the tough questions. And they, at the end, they give their opinion. And that sets the candidate off for the future.
Dave Lang, president of the Professional Firefighters of New Hampshire, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, Adam.